Hello everyone, welcome back to Coding Phrase.
So, in today's session, we are going to see code counters, collections in counter. So, let us get into that. So, what is a counter? What does a counter mean? So, we know that counter will count the number of occurrences like that, right?
Yes.
So, counter is a container. It is a container which will hold the value. It is included in the collection module. So we know that with the objects or anything which will hold, it is called as a container. So in the Python, it is also the same, which holds the objects is called as a container. So it provides the way to access the contained objects and iterate over them. So the best examples of the containers are tuples, list, and dictionaries, because it will hold the values, it will hold the objects or values. So that's why those are the best examples for containers. So container is this counter is a subclass of dictionary, and this is an equivalent. This collection is an another collection called the dictionary, and it is equivalent to bag. Means it will hold different items with the we can have the different items like that, but like it is a multi set of other languages. And coming to the syntax, we will go with like class collections dot counter, either iterable or mapping. We will go with iterable or mapping. And by initializing, you can go with any of the three following ways, which is the constructor of the counter, you can recall. So these are the three different ways. You can go with the sequence of items, or you can go with the dictionaries, or you can go with keyword argument mapping, like A equal to A, direct mapping. So any ways you can go. So let us take a simple example. So here I am showing you three ways. So with the keyword argument, and with the mapping, and with the dictionaries. So you can see here, I have given print counter, B, B, A, A, different values. Here I have given the sequence of items I have given here. And here I have given the dictionaries. Counter A with 2, A with 3, like that, I have given the dictionaries. And here I have given the keyword arguments. Like that mapping I have given here. So you can see here, it will count the values. How many number of occurrences of B? How many number of occurrences of C? It will give you. B is 5, A is 3, C is 2, like this. Whereas dictionary you get and the keyword arguments you get. So all the ways you can go. And you can also update the values. See, how can you update the counter values? You may have in the doc, right? So first you will create an empty counter. You can also create an empty counter. How can you create an empty counter is, you will assign an object for any of the object, like COUN. Here I have assigned a variable COUN equal to collections dot counter. Like this I have created an empty counter, and I'm going to update here with this variable COUN.update of data. So whatever the data I want, here I will pass the data. So let us see with a simple example. So this is an example which I have given. So here I have given 1, 2. Actual data is this, and I'm trying to update with this value. So you can see the output. The occurrences of 1 is 1, 2, 3, 4. So you will get 1 is 4 and 2 is 3. 1, 2 and 3. And 3 is only 1 occurrence. See, when you are updating this 1 to 4, it will be increased with 1. 1 is increased 4 to 5 and 2 is increased with 3 to 4 and 4 is increased with 1. So this is how you can update the counter as well. And also you can subtract also. You see here what I'm going to try is, so here data can be provided in any of the three ways as mentioned above, and it can be increased but cannot be replaced. It can be increased. So count can be 0 and negative also. It can be 0 or negative. So here I'm trying to subtract the values. So while I'm subtracting, I may get the negative values also. When I'm subtracting the lower number to higher number, I will get the negative values as well, right? So here I'm subtracting this C1 to C2, C1 minus C2. So when I'm subtracting 4 minus 10, I will be getting minus 6, and I will be getting B as 0, and I will be getting C as 6. So you can see here, AC is 6, B is 0, and A is minus 6. So I'm calling C1 dot subtract of C2. So this is how the counter can be. Counter can get the zero values as well as the negative values as well. So this is how you can update. And coming to count, so you can also count the distinct elements. So here I have given the distinct elements. Like in the before example, we have given only alphabets like A, B, C, like that, right? Here I have given blue, red, blue. So like different values I have given here. So you can, it will also count the distinct values, like how many number of occurrences of blue. So here is 3, red 2, blue 2, like that. So the number of occurrences it will give you here like this. So you can also try with the new values, like we can give like our own values like coding. So you can also see you will get one value like this. So this is how the counter can be done. So we have seen how the counter has been updated and how the counter is used with the help of corrections. That's all for this video. Thank you everyone. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.